Stop. Just hold me close inside your arms tonight. Don't be too hard on my emotions, 'cause I need time. My heart is numb, has no feeling, so while I'm still healing, just try. I really wanna start over again. I know you wanna be my salvation, the one that I can always.
Okay, right. Good morning, everyone. Give me a wave. Fantastic. I hope you've all had a fantastic half-term break. I certainly have. It's been really lovely to be able to do it. And today we have got our first opportunity to be back together again, which is lovely, and our first live assembly of our final half-term of this year. And it's lovely to see our year six children that are on in the assembly. We've got some classes that aren't able to be here in the assembly today. Including 6N, who are, I think, doing cricket coaching. But it's lovely to see the year six children who are on the screen. I'm going to highlight them just for everyone else to see. Are wearing their Leavers hoodies. So fantastic. It's great to see you wearing those. And I'm sure you'll see some year sixes around the place as we go. Now, here we go. Oh, giving a bit of a tour around 6S. That's fantastic. Brilliant. Fantastic. Okay, so I'm going to just go back to my gallery view here and want to talk about today's assembly. Now, I'm going to apologise that I've been a little bit remiss this morning and I've forgotten to collect up the team points and do the get the shout out box in. So Mrs. Bailey is rapidly going around collecting those for me. We'll bring them in at some point during the assembly. And just to let you all know that I'm recording the assembly this morning so that year three and 6N can see it later. Now, you heard as we started off, Patience by Take That. And this week we are going to be, for our theme for our assemblies, we're looking again at the fruits of the Spirit. And this week it is all about patience. And Mrs. Bailey is just popping stuff in now as we speak. Thank you. So it's all about patience this week. And I don't know how good you are at waiting for things, but sometimes I'm not brilliant, I have to say. Sometimes I find it quite hard to think about the things I've got to do. And I like to get things done quickly. You've probably spotted that about me but sometimes you have to wait. Sometimes you have to take time. And over the course of this half term, one of the things that I did was I ran a marathon. You probably, most of you year four, five and six know that I've run some marathons before. I'm not particularly quick, but it's something that I did over the half term. And I ran a virtual marathon. So it was because we can't run full races at the moment because you've got to can't have this with the social distancing and everything. But I ran by myself from Hungerford to Reading along the canal, which was great. Really enjoyed it. But to be able to do that, I had to take a lot of steps beforehand. So right the way back in January, I started my training for the marathon. I had to do five runs every week. And I had to start up, I built up. So my longest run each week built up from 9 miles at the beginning, building up eventually to my very longest run in early May of 20 miles. And then I had to do a taper to get ready so that my body was ready for the marathon. So gradually reducing it each time. And then had the marathon on the Saturday of the half term, and I had to think about all the things that I needed to do. I had to get all my preparations ready, had to get my car parked in Reading, had to take the train to Hungerford, get to the place where I was starting from, and then I had to take my first step. Now, I know how many steps my marathon took me because I wore my Fitbit for it, and it took me over 45,000 steps to run my marathon. But it had to begin with one step, and I had to be patient, knowing that each step I took, I was getting one step closer to my goal. And I'm going to share a short video with you now, which is about another really hard endurance thing, something that I would love to do one day, but I don't think I ever will, which is climbing Mount Everest. This is a short time-lapse video. It's just 3 minutes long, but it is showing all the steps that someone has had to go through to climb Mount Everest. And it's pretty impressive, I think, when I looked at it earlier. So here we go. Let's get the right thing. That is, take that. We'll get the right. Here we go. Watch this. Now, there we go. So I'm going to find, I can't actually see anyone on screen anymore suddenly. There we go. So that was pretty impressive, I think, being that ability to climb Mount Everest, that starting as one small point and all those things that you have to do to be able to get there. And even that, once you've got there, once you've achieved that, you still have to take all those steps to get back down again. You know, you don't know if it's going to be airlifted off the top. It's pretty difficult stuff, pretty impressive. Now, the thing is, for all of us, we all have difficult challenges that we have to achieve. For year sixes, it's going to be going to secondary school in a few weeks' time. For all of us, there's all sorts of challenges we have to do. And it's really important to start one step at a time. That's the way to get the patience that we need. So I just want you to imagine the following scenario. So your teacher asks you and a friend to clean up the paint cupboard. You open the doors and look inside. The shelves are full of paint pots, brushes, mixing trays, all completely covered in paint. And you panic and think, oh, I'm never going to get this done by home time. So you stand there wondering what to do, and your friend says, well, let's collect all the mixing trays and we'll wash them first. So together you do that and you leave them to dry. After that, you suggest taking out all the paint pots to wash. You leave them to dry as well. Well, that only leaves the brushes. Your friend passes them to you and you wash them. By now, the mixing pot trays and the paint pots are dry. You can put them back in the cupboard. You put the brushes in a jar and you close the cupboard door. Bell rings, it's home time, and you've finished. You didn't think you'd be able to finish in time, but it's so much easier when you do things one step at a time. So just have a think about that. We need to take things one step at a time. Don't rush ahead of yourselves. Be patient. Think about what you can achieve and do those small steps, and then you can achieve really big things. Let's pray. Dear God, please help us when we have to do something hard. Help us to see what needs to be done first. Keep us calm to work out what needs to be done next. Give us patience to keep on going to the next step. Help us to keep going to the end until it's finished and we can enjoy our success. Amen. I'm just going to share a song, a hymn, now for us to listen to sing together in your class if you'd like to do so. It's Living and Learning. Here we go. Okay, I am going to grab the shout-out box now from down here, which just fallen on the floor. Here we go. We've got, have got some shout-outs in here this morning. I'm going to empty them out, and there we go. I think that's all of them. Here we go. Shout-outs this morning to Erin, Anika, and Eleanor for being kind and helpful. Well done. To Charlie and Cody for helping me. Got one for Toby, Dan, Jamie, Thomas L and Thomas. I have one for Shay for trying her best in everything. Nice one. Shout out to Miss McCabe and Mrs. Jehan for helping me with my work. A shout out to all the 6N girls. Got a shout out to Ibby for when someone was sad, he let them take his place so they were happier. That's really nice. Done, Ibby. A shout out to Naisha, Sambi, Freddie T and Harry K and 5S for always helping me in their own way to sort out school dinners. Jamie is really kind because he gave me Haribo, Oreos and mini cookies. Right, okay. A shout out to 4S. To the cooks for the best cooking on Monday. For Poppy A and Lemiz for running the half mile, running the Daily Mile, with me. That's a nice one. To Poppy A in 4S for being a great friend. This one's to Jude in 4S for helping me. I have one for Evan and Tyler and Jude for playing with me. This one is for Miss McKay for being the best in 4S. To everyone for trying their best on Wednesday. There we go. That's for everybody for trying their best on Wednesday. Shout out to Luca for giving me tips. Well done, Luca. To Tanishka for being the best friend. Shout out to Clara H and Clara W for always being happy. To Kruthi in year six for always being the best friend ever. Shout out to Mr. Harvey. That's nice. Well, this one's been folded like a thousand times. And it hasn't got anything on it. That's helpful. A shout out to Poppy S and Hattie from 4S. Shout out to Mia for playing with me at lunchtime and break time. Shout out to Shay and Emily for playing with me. And Daisy and Freya and Dara for making me happy. And that's all of them. So fantastic. Well done to everyone with the shout outs. And I do now have the Team Point trophy, which I'm sorry I haven't managed to get into year six. So we will not be able to have team captains today. But in fourth place, this was for the week at the end of last half term, with 357 team points, was the blue team. Congratulations, Blues. Give them a round of applause. In third place with 405 team points was the red team. Congratulations, Reds. Give them a round of applause. So we know it is between green and yellow. One of those teams had 411 team points. The other team had 437. And the winning team with 437 team points was the yellow team. Congratulations, Yellows. Well done. Well done to all of you. I will take the trophy through to year six so we can officially award it to our yellow team captains. Well done. So thank you all for joining us today. Let's have a every class of signing off with a bit of a cheer and a wave. So first one on my screen is 4S. Bye, 4S. Fantastic. And 4N. And I've got 5N. And 6S.
Okay.
Oh, they are there. They are there. Brilliant. And 5S. Well, I think 5S won the noisiest class there. Well done, 5S. Fantastic. Lovely to see you all. Have a great week. Bye.